an epidemic affecting millions of families across the nation today. H-Hemp products produce a sense of calm, fight post-workout inflammation, and the company gives back to our community. What more could we ask for? Search online for H-Hemp Company and use the code OLR for 20% off your first order. That's OLR for 20% off your first order.
Hi, I'm Bob Barker, and this is my friend Benny. Before you buy cosmetics, personal care, or household products, you be sure they have not been tested on animals. Everything from floor cleaner to shampoo is poured into animals' eyes and down their throats. They suffer intensely. Some even go blind. The price is never right for products tested on animals. Visit PETA.org for a list of cruelty-free companies.
Whoever said you can't poop in style? The Curve is a sleeker version of the original Squatty Potty stool that will look fabulous in any bathroom. Choose from pink, black, gray, or white. Its minimalist design is sure to please the eye while staying durable and built to last. Go to squattypotty.com/onelife for 15% off your entire purchase. Poop, poop, be do.
This is Jill with the One Life Radio Fueling Champions Minute. Did you know magnesium is a cofactor in more than 300 enzyme systems that regulate diverse biochemical reactions in the body, including protein synthesis, muscle and nerve function, blood glucose control, and blood pressure? Magnesium is required for energy production, oxidative phosphorylation, and glycolysis. That's a mouthful. How do you know if you're getting enough? Signs and symptoms of possible magnesium deficiency include restless leg syndrome, agitation, insomnia, muscle stiffness, cramping, and aches. Well, where do you find magnesium? Food sources include raw almonds, leafy greens like cooked spinach and chard, raw cashews, pumpkin seeds, black beans, avocados, and my favorite, dark chocolate. Don't forget those Epsom salt baths and be smart about supplementation. This has been the One Life Radio Fueling Champions Minute.
Did you know a mother rat will dip her paws into cool water and gently smooth the fur around her infants' faces? The babies put their arms around their mother's neck and pay attention while being bathed. Rats and mice fall in love, risk their lives to save their kids, and giggle when tickled. Evan Walker writes of a mouse who died of shock in a trap. His life was a life fully as real to him as ours is to us. This creature, for all the irritation it may have brought as it scampered through closed closets or up some crevice in a wall, was as precious as you or I. He was not a machine that breaks and fails. He felt. His was consciousness, full and real and fragile and precious. This is Ingrid Newkirk with Peter, reminding us that it's easy to be kind, perhaps by not using glue traps.
This is Daniel.
Oh, Daniel, you got to get this one. Come on, man.
AC/DC. I went with my first
instinct. Letters. It's letters like that.
I recognize the song.
CCR.
CCR?
CCR.
CCR. Clearwater. Clearwater Revival.
I never gotten it. But I recognize it. I recognize the
song. And Marvin Gaye remade this later.
Really?
Yeah. It's a great song.
I like the song.
I love CCR. You do too, don't you?
Yeah, I love them.
I love them. Just love them. And one of my favorite bands to dance to on my Sonos system that I love so much.
But I love Victoria even more.
Exactly. Everyone, welcome back to One Life Radio. We've got Victoria Field on the line. She and Shawn Wells are huge fans of the ketogenic diet and exercise. That's their diet. They exercise that diet in their own life. And so it's so great to have you back with us, Victoria. Let me just give you, give our listeners that maybe are just now joining us, like a quick bio of both you and Shawn, if they've just jumped on the air with us. Victoria Field has more than 15 years of experience in the fitness and nutrition industry and has spearheaded cancer-focused pilot studies in partnership with oncologists and institutions, including Cedars-Sinai Medical Center. She is a former professional athlete in the International Federation of Bodybuilding and Fitness, but most importantly, Victoria is passionate about educating people about the ketogenic diet, and in an effort to do so, she co-founded Metabolic Health Initiative, an organization that hosts a large annual scientific conference called the Metabolic Health Summit in Los Angeles, California. It's coming up in January. I will be there.
Will you be there? Yeah.
And I know, Victoria, you'll be there. You're running it. So
I'll be running around at the conference, yes.
Yeah, I know that drill.
It is my favorite. The prior iteration of it is the best conference I've ever been to.
Really?
Just loaded with brilliant people from the industry and academics. It's incredible. And this one's going to be 10 times better than that. So, anyone who's interested in the future, it's well beyond the ketogenic diet. It's more like, that's why she named it Metabolic Health Summit.
Mm-hmm. It's the end of January, right?
It's brilliant. If you want to know the future of medicine, like, this is where you want to go.
Oh, wow. That is a big statement. Nice. Right?
It's January 31st through February 3rd. And we really are focused on bringing nutrition and metabolism into the picture and more to the forefront, really, when it comes to treating disease, extending life, and improving just overall human performance and feeling better. So we have physician speakers, scientists, I mean, the top people in the world, as well as thought leaders, to literally showcase the latest science and research that's going on and sort of involving metabolic health, whether it's what you eat, to fasting, to sleep, stress, all of those things. And then also we've got some great influencers who are really going to show us how to put that to life in the kitchen and beyond. And they've got cooking demonstrations. We actually have an amazing gala dinner entertainment segment where a brain tumor survivor, he's actually been diagnosed with 4 brain tumors. He's a professional BMX.
Josh Perry.
He's going to be performing.
My buddy.
Ramp.
Will Dr. Will Cole be there as well? I'm kind of a ketotarian. That's kind of how I eat.
Dr. Will Cole,
he's been on the show before. I didn't introduce Shawn Wells. Shawn Wells, for everyone out there, is a certified sports nutritionist and fellow through the very prestigious International Society of Sports Nutrition. He has been dubbed the world's greatest formulator and has credentials in the fields of business, clinical work, sports, exercise, and nutrition, making for a unique and highly respected blend of expertise as CEO of Zone Halo Research. He is also a registered dietitian and has his Master's of Public Health in Nutritional Biochemistry. And you can find Shawn Wells on Instagram at Zone Halo or at shawnwells.com. So I'm going to ask the two of you this question, or maybe Shawn, I'll start with you. Can you tell us why you live a ketogenic lifestyle? What made you go to ketogenic?
Yeah, early on, probably, you know, similar to Victoria, like, you know, she started out in fitness and bodybuilding. I was interested in it more from an aesthetic standpoint, just as a way to lose fat mass quickly. And it works really well for that. But I've grown up with a lot of autoimmune issues, chronic fatigue syndrome, fibromyalgia. I have a pituitary adenoma. Exactly. And it was incredible at reducing my inflammation and fatigue. I found when I did like a very pure version of the ketogenic diet and even fasted some that I felt like this immense burst of energy and reduction in inflammation. And when you have chronic inflammation, you know, you just have like a brain fog all the time. Mm-hmm. Speaking back to that neuroinflammation I was talking about. Mm-hmm. And it was just like somebody turned on the light bulb for me, and I've kind of never looked back. And it's been 20 years that I've been doing it, and I love it. And you know, got Daniel on it.
Lean, getting those arms all big over there.
I'm curious to hear with you, Victoria. Victoria, you actually have some interesting experiences with the ketogenic diet, with your lipids and those kind of things, right?
Oh yeah, that we could definitely go down a good rabbit hole with that. I started when, you know, kind of similar to Shawn, when there really wasn't a whole lot of information. Like right now, keto's a buzzword, but at the time it was like we were sort of shooting in the dark and sort of designing our own programs based off of how it's been used with epilepsy, but more so a lifestyle approach. And I actually started because my dog suffered a traumatic brain injury when she was 6 months old from a dog bite, and she started to develop grand mal seizures. And at the time, friends of mine, Ron and Shannon Penna, were starting KetoPet Sanctuary, and I was getting involved. And you know, while they were focusing on cancer, it obviously had been used with children with epilepsy. So we decided to give it a go with our dog, who was not experiencing mm-hmm. seizure control, even with drugs. And we put her on the diet, and we now completely control her seizures through food. And
wow.
I saw that. Yeah. And I said, okay, I've got to give this a try. It was completely different to how I led my life as a professional athlete. I mean, I was, you know, eating carbs like it was my job, because it kind of was at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And it changed my life as soon as I made that decision. I actually got injured at the same time we had transitioned my dog onto a ketogenic diet. And I started it, and I've never looked back. And it's because of the cognitive function that you get from it. I mean, mm-hmm. I've done TV news and radio and all that great stuff. And if I didn't eat before I went live on the air, it was like I couldn't think straight.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's like exactly the opposite. When I don't eat, when I'm in a higher level of sort of ketosis, it's like my brain works better.
Mm-hmm.
So that for me was really life-changing, as well as the freedom that I think you get from not having those blood glucose insulin spikes all day mm-hmm. long. It's like this steady flow of energy. And that for me, physically, emotionally, just, you know, even in my dog, was really life-changing mm-hmm. and what, you know, made me sick and then tell everybody I know.
Well, you know what you guys just made me think of? So I lost my brother, Mike, about 10 years ago from the complications from the heavy pharmaceuticals that he was on for grand mal seizures. They couldn't shut him down, and they had to put him on very heavy doses. Make a long story short, it damaged his liver till the point he went into liver failure and died. And I wonder, I'm sitting here wondering if the ketogenic diet could have helped him. Like I said, this was 10 years ago. We really didn't have any knowledge about the ketogenic. Well, we do have knowledge. It's 100 years old, like you said, but the medical community does not promote it. I don't understand why.
There's no money.
Well, it's
yeah.
Yeah, there's
think
that.
About that.
It's also, yeah, I mean, it's interesting because it's, I think it's been sort of set in stone as sort of a standard of care for childhood epilepsy, because the classic ketogenic diet is traditionally known to be very obviously low in protein. If you're going to have four parts, you know, fat to protein plus net carbs, it's going to be obviously very low in protein. So they felt like, you know, maybe that might not be suitable for adults. And it really never was brought up in the conversation. However, there's a variety of physicians. There is Dr. Eric Kossoff, who is part of the sort of creation of the modified Atkins diet, which is something that still in some children and adults, it's more widely used in young adults, has been shown to help in seizure reduction. But that said, there is so much work that still needs to be done in mm-hmm. helping educate for adults with epilepsy. I mean, I know many adults who aren't even really familiar with the ketogenic
right.
diet. And I think it's an exciting time to see more and more
yeah.
progressive physicians become on board and really start speaking about these nutritional options in combination with standard of care. I think that's really an exciting time, and
mm-hmm.
I think we're just going to see it snowball effect, you know, over the next few years as well.
Well, I hope you'll come back and help us educate. I've really enjoyed having you on the air with us today.
Thanks, Victoria.
Thank you guys so much. It was so great to chat with you all.
All right. Well, we'll talk to you soon. Thank you so much. Everyone, we've got to go to break. We've got Daniel Tague. He's going to be talking about being prepared for holiday travel. We've got a great personal story to tell you about Lexi when we get back. Stay tuned, everyone. You're listening to One Life Radio.
Introducing Moonlight, the latest squat to poop stool from Squatty Potty. Moonlight will light your way to the toilet on the darkest of nights. May your love of Squatty Potty burn brightly day or night with a motion and light activated nightlight with three brightness settings. Go to squattypotty.com/onelife for 15% off your entire purchase. Follow the moonlight.
Hey, this is Shawn Wells of the International Society of Sports Nutrition. One Life Radio is proud to partner with the ISSN. The ISSN is the world's leading scientific organization dedicated to the science of supplements and sports nutrition. For their latest conferences and events, go to theissn.org. That's theissn.org.
Hi, everyone. This is Bernadette. Do you know why I love Paleo Magazine? Paleo Magazine was founded with the purpose of providing readers with the information they need to live strong, vibrant, healthy lives. They are dedicated to partnering with leaders in the paleo community to spread the knowledge of ancestral health principles without the influence of big pharma or big agriculture. Paleo Magazine. Follow them on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram, or visit them at paleomagonline.com. That's paleomagonline.com.
Here's the dill pickle. Squatty Potty works. It's awesome. Find your